Hello YouTube, this is Andy once again, coming to you with a computer build video where I discuss parts for computer build. Now this build is for those who only want to browse the web, store the pictures, the music, watch the movies online on the computer, and so on. Just remember that this video is just for fun. And I'm not advertising anything whatsoever except for the parts that I think can be good for this kind of build. So, before I get started, let me just point out that I am in the front room of my house. Therefore, you may hear some cars going by, and you may also hear some people talking in the background at points, or maybe some music playing. So, I'm sorry about that, and let's get started. So here I'm going to jump over from the webcam over to a screen recorder on my laptop, I mean my desktop. So get started. Okay, it is Andy, and I am back. So here you see my desktop, and now I'm on Chrome, and here is the parts list for this video. So as I have stated in previous videos, I am visually impaired, so here we go. For the processor, I went with an AMD 5350 clocked at 2.05 GHz quad core processor. It has Radeon HD 8400 graphics, does not use hyper-threading, it includes the cooler. It uses 25 watts of power. It is 64-bit on socket AM1. Now for the motherboard, I went with the Gigabyte GAAM1-S28 Micro ATX AM1 motherboard. Here are some pictures of it. On the back is the audio jacks, Ethernet, USB 2.0, USB 3.0, HDMI, VGA, PS2 keyboard, and PS2 mouse. Specs for this motherboard is a Mercury GX board, CPU socket is AM1. Chipset is AMD AM1. Memory configuration is memory slot configuration is 2x240 pin DIMM, which supports DDR3, 1333 MHz or 1600 MHz. Maximum supply memory is 2 GB. There is no RAID support on the video, depending on CPU. And as I have mentioned before, the CPU does have the Radeon graphics. This board does not support Crossfire or SLI. There are two SATA 6 GB/s ports. It includes Ethernet, and there is no onboard USB 3.0 headers. In the background, you see my phone. Sorry about that. Let's see. For the memory, I went with Crucial 4 GB, 2x2 GB DDR3 1600 MHz memory. For the hard drive, I went with Western Digital AV-GP 500 GB, 3.5-inch internal hard drive at 5400 RPM. Which works 5% of the build. The case is the Roosevelt SRM01 Micro ATX Mini Tower case. So this case includes on front USB 3.0 headers, and it includes front USB 3.0 ports, and the motherboard does not include USB 3.0 headers. But if it is needed, you can go on Amazon or somewhere and buy a USB 3.0 hub or use the USB 3.0 ports on the back of the motherboard. So this case specifications are: it is a Micro ATX Mini Tower, color is black, obviously. It does not include a power supply. It has one internal 5.25 inch bays, two internal 3.5 bays, which is going to be for the hard drives or SSDs if you want an SSD in there in the future. The 5.25 inch bays are for the optical drive. Motherboard supported is Micro ATX or Mini ITX. And here are the rest of the specifications. So here this maximum video card length supported is 11.81 inches. I did not include a video card for this build because this build is supposed to be for just for those who want to browse the web and, you know, do everyday tasks like that. I mean, it's also for those who don't have a money to spend on an off-the-shelf computer. Because I mean, for a quad-core processor, but these same specs, you're gonna be paying like $400 for something like that, which it's gonna not understand the whole logic behind that. But it's better to just build a computer for cheaper and get the same specs and then upgrade on it later. So power supply it went to us is the EVGA 500 watt 80 plus certified ATX power supply, and the optical driver went with the ASUS the RW-24F1ST DVD CD writer. So now I'm going to show you the price of everything. CPU, motherboard, memory, hard drive, case, power supply, and the DVD drive. Another drive is under promotion right now. As of filming this video, the drive is under promotion. And here is the full price breakdown. Now, as for the operating system, if you want to use Windows, you'll have to buy a new copy of Windows unless you have one lying around. Or if you don't want to spend extra money on the operating system, you can look into a free OS like Ubuntu Linux. Ubuntu Linux is one I heard of that's really good. And it's free. You just go onto their website and download it into a DVD or a flash drive, and then you would boot from the hard drive, from the flash drive or DVD, and install the OS. And I mean, the good thing about those is that they have on the CD, on the DVDs or the flash drive that you put it onto. They have what's called a live environment where you can just try it out for free. I mean, everything, the whole thing is free. For those operating systems like Ubuntu. I have a disk right here that I used before. So you could just get a DVD like this and install and burn an OS like Ubuntu that's free onto it, and then you put in the drive, and then you get two options. One that says try it or install it. So, I mean, if you're somebody who is not very tech savvy and you don't have money to spend, you can try something like this and then try it out, see how it works for you. If it works for you, fine, then you go ahead and install it. If it doesn't work for you, fine, then you go online and you Google free operating systems, and hopefully the other reference for free will allow you to burn it to a disk or a flash drive. You can put it into a flash drive and then try it for free and then install it for free. And or you can use Windows, whatever. So I just thought that I would point those things out, because this build is basically for somebody who doesn't have a lot of money to spend. So once again, my name is Andy. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoy. Have a great day. Remember to comment, like, and subscribe for more.